Jameson Olonya, the president of the Ugandan National Association of Building and Civil Engineering Contractors, has brought to the attention of the Committee on Physical Infrastructure the outstanding arrears which UNRWA owes local contractors amounting to 500 billion shillings. He told members of parliament that contractors are losing everything they used as security to secure loans so as to execute government projects.
As you will appreciate, there are a number of other contractors that are in the country at the moment. Some of them are functioning under donor funding, and some of them may not be as much affected. But our biggest challenge is the local providers, the main partners, especially under the funding that comes from government. And so it is the local providers that are really, really affected by the matters of delayed payment.
They have also decried overwhelming accumulating tax penalties from URA.
Especially from the penalties point of view, in that irrespective of the above persistent challenges, Uganda Revenue Authority is continuously harassing our members on account of delay in remitting value-added tax, with penalties of monthly 2% interest on tax arrears.
Chair, I wonder how this government works sometimes. We are the people who are charged with the responsibility of appropriation. You go to cabinet, suppress. It's good because of we do within what we have within our means. But why do you go ahead and suppress some key sectors like transport and works? It was very unfortunate. Now, some roads are impassable.
The current arrears attract a daily interest of 140 million shillings to the side of government. The executive director of the Uganda National Roads Authority, Allen Kajina, has attributed the delays to the budget suppression by government, which she says affected all agencies. The Uganda National Roads Authority is concerned that the crisis is going to stall ongoing road construction projects.
Honorable Chair and honorable members, following budget suppression of this financial year, Uganda National Roads Authority has faced challenges regarding the implementation of NDP3 projects that fall within our mandate of road construction and maintenance. Honorable Chair and members, we appreciate and totally support the government decision to suppress the budget for financial year by 40% due to poor revenue performance and effects of COVID-19. The communication for budget suppression came in July 2021 when UNRWA had already signed contracts that could not be revoked.
A crisis given the issue of COVID, but at the same time we have an obligation as government to ensure that we don't collapse our indigenous companies completely. So I think it's our duty and responsibility as a committee. This issue is beyond us. I'm not finance anywhere in the communication and correspondence coming out to address this issue. But without funding this sector, whatever we are doing, whether parish model or Myoga, it is actually an exercise in futility.
Members of the Committee on Physical Infrastructure have resolved to meet the President and forge a solution to the accrued arrears of the contractors.
Let us not waste time with anybody. Chair, from here, let us make a resolution, schedule an appointment. We go to meet the Constitutional Minister of Finance. Take him through the cries of people. Let him also read this document, self-explanatory. Let him face us from the other side. We take ourselves on. We don't leave the burden to the Minister of Works alone. We don't leave the burden to the ED because the ED will fear for her job. The Minister will fear for the appointment. Me, who is only voted by the people of Bugabula, I will take him on. Chair, there is one Constitutional Minister of Finance. He is the only person who plans for this country, who takes a decision. The rest we are wasting.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.